Now I want to show you one more thing that you could do with the event object. This web page that I've made answers the eternal question, what does Ono say? Or more specifically, what would he sound like if you could hear him? If you click on the link, you'll be brought to an MP3 file that should play in the browser and answer that burning question for you. However, I don't want the user to have to leave the web page. You should be able to hear it directly on the page. We can do that with JavaScript by playing an audio tag as soon as the user clicks the link. First, let's store the link in a variable. Var onos l equals document.getElementById onos onos. Now let's define a callback function. This is going to be a pretty interesting one. So in that callback function, we want to create an audio tag dynamically. So audio l equals document.createElementAudio. And this is a nice new tag available in modern browsers. And then audio.src equals, and we're going to set it equal to what the href is up here. The audio tag is a lot like the image tag, audio l. And then we're also going to say audio l.autoplay equals true. That'll just make it play as soon as we add it to the page. And finally, we add it to the page. And it doesn't really matter where I put it since we're not really visualizing it. So now, when they click, it should create an audio, set the source, set it to autoplay, and add it to the page. Finally, we make sure that the event listener is called when the link is clicked. So onosl.addEventListener, click, and then we just pass in the name of the function. Okay, you know the deal. Pause the talkthrough, try it out. Do-do-do. What happened? For me, the sound plays, that low, deep grumble of oh no's. But the link still opens up in a new window. Ideally, once that sound played, the browser would no longer try to navigate the user to the link, because they've already heard it. The way to do this is to tell the browser to cancel its default behavior. You see, by default, when a user clicks a link, the browser navigates the user to that link. But if we've overridden the way that the link works in JavaScript, we often don't want the browser to do that navigation. We can tell it to stop by using a method on the event property called preventDefault. So we need to refer to that event object that we get passed. And then inside here, we say e.preventDefault. This should tell the browser to prevent the default behavior associated with this event. Now pause the talkthrough and try it again. You just heard the sound, right? That is a much nicer user experience. And that is what is known as progressive enhancement. Starting the web page's HTML with the default browser behavior, but then enhancing it with JavaScript to be a richer experience. You'll often want to use this prevent default when you're attaching click listeners to links, and you may also find yourself using it when you're doing form processing, since the browser does some default behavior there as well, submitting to a server. The important thing is to keep the user experience in mind, and if the user experience isn't optimal on your web page, figure out how to make it better. We may not be able to teach you everything here, but the internet has thousands of answers for you.